India, a land where enormous diversity exists in perfect harmony since time immemorial. A quest for oneness amidst this magnitude of diversity was pioneered by a saffron-clad young monk, Swami Vivekananda. He had dreamt of a nation and a society that would be driven by love for all humanity. His entire life was dedicated to this single goal, and his life's work had initiated the making of this modern Indian nation nearly a century ago. Celebrates the 150th birth anniversary of this visionary. Its grand inauguration took place on the 12th of January 2011. The Honorable Prime Minister of India had officially launched a host of sustained value education programs and service-oriented projects on that day, in the presence of the General Secretary of the Ramakrishna Mission, coordinated all across the nation by the National Implementation Committee. This massive endeavor is since being executed by one of India's largest voluntary service organizations, the Ramakrishna Mission, which was founded by Swami Vivekananda himself. India, the world's largest democracy, is rushing headlong into the future, moving towards becoming a global superpower within just 66 years of its independence. But there still remains pockets of backward areas that are still victim to maladies like malnutrition, illiteracy, and unemployment. A degrading value system is another area of concern which is affecting the country's youth. The 150th birth anniversary celebration actively intends to defeat these backdraws through the man-making and character-building philosophy of Swami Vivekananda. Various service-oriented projects, value-added educational programs, and other different activities have been scheduled to be achieved between the years of 2010 and 2014 for this purpose. Under its service activity project, Ramakrishna Mission has launched an integrated child development project for underprivileged children. The Gadadhar Abhyuday Prakalpa, or GAP, is not just about conventional education, but also essentially about man-making education through all-round development, where food, clothing, education, medicine, and all other basic needs of the students are taken care of by the mission. Vivekananda Swasthya Pariseva Prakalpa, or VSPP, targets healthcare on a regular basis for underprivileged children, along with pregnant and lactating mothers. Sarada Palli Vikas Prakalpa, or SPVP, is a women's empowerment project active in rural and tribal areas. It is materializing the dream of self-reliance among thousands of rural, backward, deprived women. Poverty alleviation is a major challenge in rural India. Met methodically by the mission through the Akhandananda Seva Prakalpa, or AKSP. A sustained, graded, value-added education program has also been launched throughout the nation by conducting various youth special programs and youth camps across different age groups. Another unique approach by Ramakrishna Mission is the curriculum-based books on value education researched and developed by Belur Math. These books are distributed to school children as a part of moral education across the country. Our journey to gather a first-hand impression of these massive activities begins from the northeast corner of India, nested in the lap of the Himalayas, the seven states of Northeast India are known as the Seven Sisters. This region of the country is unique in its distinct culture, traditions, and tribes. One of these states, Meghalaya, is the land of stunning scenic beauty. But inaccessibility of the terrain has left many parts of the state out of touch from modern facilities. Most of its inhabitants are from different tribal cultures. The town of Cherrapunji at one time held the world record for highest monthly rainfall. Many villages around this town are geographically difficult to reach. Cherrapunji is an effective hub for the existing network of the Ramakrishna Mission to implement some very important service activities in remote locations. 48 kilometers away from Cherrapunji, the remote village of Kalatek is on the Indian border with Bangladesh. The river Kalatek isolates this village from the rest of Meghalaya. In a permanent state of crisis, life here, amidst guns and barbed wire, is a daily challenge. The fight for survival every day shrouds any concept of nationalism. Education here is a far-flung fantasy, and the nearest Indian town is many miles away. Ramakrishna Mission's GAP initiative is a ray of hope for the deprived people. Keeping Vivekananda's philosophy in mind that education must reach out to people if they cannot come to education, around 100 kids have been enrolled in this project. Quality education and constant health awareness is helping them to build their all-round personality. They believe that this school is the gateway to interact with the mainstream. A mobile van comprising of a medical unit touches many remote villages on its way under the VSPP project. The van visits Ichhamati, which is 42 kilometers from Cherrapunji, consisting of a migrant Bangladeshi population. The mobile van is like a boon to the people there, especially for women and children who are completely ignorant about basic health issues. Through VSPP, a change in health awareness is being brought at the very grassroots level. This program thus ensures a healthier tomorrow for these people. Through the winding paths of the beautiful Jayantia Hills, 130 kilometers away from Cherrapunji, the mobile van negotiates its way to a village called Natyang, primarily oriented by Jayantia tribes. These locals suffer from waterborne diseases since many generations. The weekly visit of the VSPP project van spearheads its full efforts to eradicate these severe diseases. Mm-hmm. The distribution of water filters among the locals make them aware of the concept of safe drinking water. The enthusiastic participation of the children in these activities gives us the hope that the good practices among all members of the family will create a village with healthy smiles. Pinsula, located 30 kilometers from Cherrapunji, consists of a Khasi population. They survive in extremely poor socio-economic condition. On top of this, the heavy rainfall and improper food habits plague the population with numerous chronic diseases. Ramakrishna Mission Cherrapunji's noble objective sends this mobile van to this village community hall.
You have to boil properly, then you take. Otherwise, you may suffer from worms.
When I get the advice from the doctor, so I cook properly my food.
This constant awareness relieves them from age-long unawareness with the mainstream. One of the most famous hill stations of India, Shillong, stands proudly as the capital of Meghalaya. Dazzling with every kind of urban facilities, Shillong offers employment opportunities to many. As a result, Shillong has a large population of migrant families with children who are school dropouts.
बच्चों ये है ग्लोब यहाँ पे हम बहुत सारे कंट्री देख सकते हैं ठीक है यहाँ पे हर जगह पर ओशंस हैं वाटर बॉडीज हैं ठीक है रिवर्स हैं यहाँ पे है हमारा देश इंडिया ठीक है बिल्कुल यहाँ पे दिखाई दे रहा है सबको
Cherrapunji Ramakrishna Mission provides them a unique opportunity through GAP to continue their education combined with all-round development.
5, 6, 7.
सुबह मैं पापा के साथ काम करता हूँ मुझे पढ़ाई अच्छा लगता है इसलिए मैं शाम को आकर स्कूल पढ़ता हूँ
Their parents now feel hopeful that their unfulfilled ambitions will finally materialize through their children. A Sikh community residing in this very city upholds a striking contrast with the mainstream city life. This slum area incorporates a total vacuum in terms of educational awareness and sensitive outlook. Ramakrishna Mission Shillong, with their GAP project, is trying to recover this deficiency by providing the slum children with proper environment. The ideology of oneness binds them together with a strong tie to their native culture. Wakhen, a remote and distant village near Shillong. The mobile van from the Shillong Ramakrishna Mission travels across challenging terrain with the firm mission of supporting these distressed lives. The VSPP program provides medical treatment, food habits, and quality education for these Senkhasi tribes.
Most of the students are very, very means cooperate with me, and I'm very grateful to see all those students. And these students, I hope so, it will be improved in the near future by the help of Ramakrishna Mission.
Ramakrishna Mission is making an all-out effort towards making a complete India enriched with the locality's vibrant culture. Umden, a village near an airport for Shillong, is another remote place. VSPP here offers quality education supported with modern technological means.
Okay, so the first point here, the first point it shows that here it is given Kajing Prakhat Janai Kalong Kavai Nakine Kimat Hashwa Vinginle Ya Kamakamakam. That means that here, before we do anything, that we have to have a details idea or a plan.
Personality development classes is another component of this initiative. This approach keeps the future generation up to date and also makes them implement their learning hands-on for social welfare. Shillong is a memorable place where Swami Vivekananda had once delivered his message in person, taking ahead his teachings. Spreading of value education forms an integral part of Ramakrishna Mission Shillong's mission. Half-day camps are organized where moral values are taught and implemented through various events. A large number of kids from different schools participate in various activities which exclusively focus upon the holistic development of the children.
Sarve bhavantu sukhinama, sarve santu niramaya, sarve bhadrani pashyantu, ma kashchit dukha bhavet.
From the northeast, we move on to West Bengal, the birthplace of Sri Ramakrishna and Ma Sharada. Kolkata, the capital of the state, is Swami Vivekananda's birthplace and also the venue for the beginning of the Ramakrishna movement. The city stretches along the banks of the holy Ganges and bears a unique combination of modernization with rich heritage. Today, this metro city is considered the most important commercial city of eastern India. But along with the success story of this city, there exists underdeveloped zones too. 10 kilometers from Kolkata, Kamarhati, near Belgoria, consists largely of a migrant Bangladeshi Muslim population living in extreme unhygienic conditions. Their homes and workplace both remains knee-deep in sewage and garbage. Education is a far-fetched dream, since the lack of stable livelihood makes literacy a luxury. After Ramakrishna Mission's persistent, year-long efforts today, Kamarhati exhibits an absolutely different scenario. Under the Gadadhar Abhyuday Prakalpa, the Belghoria Center serves 100 slum children through its evening classes. The arrival of the GAP buses in the slum creates ripples of happiness and joy amongst them. They enjoy every bit of their school, which transports them to an absolutely different universe. While the students are immersed in the world of knowledge, the ashram prepares their food with great care. After classes, they distribute the food among themselves, another delightful experience. Boranagar Math occupies a special place in the history of the Ramakrishna movement, as this was the organization's first. In this holy place, Ramakrishna Mission is running a successful SPVP initiative where hundreds of women regularly participate. Today, many women like Jhumpa lead a busy but purposeful life. Her day starts with sending her son to the GAP school run by the Boranagar Math. Then she herself gets ready for her journey to the SPVP project. Here, Jhumpa and many more women like her have found a new direction with the training and education provided by the Ramakrishna Mission. In Shargachi, a place 100 kilometers away from Kolkata, Swami Akhandananda, the brother disciple of Swami Vivekananda, had first started the service activity under the Ramakrishna movement for the poor and deprived. The Akhandananda Seva Prakalpa has been named after him. This successful AKSP project is running in Shargachi, having huge number of beneficiaries. Here they are given training in food processing techniques to make productive use of their excess produce. They also learn to manufacture soaps, incense sticks, candles, shampoo, toothpaste and perfume. Tailoring and handicrafts are also taught here, which helps them to supplement their earnings. The youth are also trained in computers and plumbing. The Shargachi people are no longer dependent only on cultivation, but have found reliable alternative sources of income to support their families. Value education in Shargachi have enormously appealed to the life and minds of the children.
যা বাইরে থেকে বিচার করে যে গুণগুলি দেখা যায় সাধারণত তাকেই পার্সোনালিটি বলা হয়।
The center distributes value education, curriculum-based books in Bengali for the moral upliftment of the students. Able facilitators conduct their classes through the help of these textbooks. The lively learning methods are evidently effective in raising the future nation. The journey now takes us to the southern part of the state. Located in the meandering flow of the river Ganges, caught in the uncertain sea tides, the delta island of Mansuadeep remained far away from the light of education till the recent past. But Ramakrishna Mission's GAP project has arrived here as a new dawn of purpose. In spite of consistent poverty, the families now send their children out to GAP schools. They learn and engage themselves in different recreational activities. The focus is on their all-round development. The people here have realized the importance of education in their lives and thus are striving hard so that their kids can reach out to a better future. Our next stop is further inland into the central part of the country. Narayanpur is a small district situated 350 kilometers from the capital of Chhattisgarh, Raipur. This district is surrounded by the Narayanpur forest, the Abujmar hills and rainwater-filled rivers. Because of their extreme geographical location and physical isolation for long, the hill Marias have a very primitive economy. Literacy is low and ill health stalks the land with malnutrition and many diseases. In this extreme terrain, education, health and a better way of life was a distant dream till the buses of the GAP began to arrive every morning. The bus spreads happiness and hope into every nook and corner of the village. Today, the families have overcome their mental resistance and feel encouraged to send their kids to the GAP school. The remoteness of this area has not prevented them from aspiring for a better tomorrow. They are glad that their children receive nutritious food and medical care along with education. Weekly value education classes are organized for the tribal school students where they learn about Indian values and about the life and teachings of Swami Vivekananda. The active participation of students in these classes shows their keen interest in these teachings.
इस value education class में हमें इस उस बात का पता चलता है कि हम अपने समाज में किस प्रकार कार्य करें।
इस class में स्वामी विवेकानंद की बातें बताई जाती है। वे कहते थे, विश्वास, 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 अपने आप पर विश्वास, यही उन्नति करने का एकमात्र उपाय है।
Now the journey moves over to the western part, to Maharashtra. the capital of Maharashtra and the commercial capital of India, metropolitan Mumbai is bordered by the vast Arabian Sea and the twinkling Marine Drive. Yet, the glamour capital of India hosts the largest slums in the subcontinent. One of these slum areas is Pratiksha Nagar, where hygienic living environment is a distant dream. These slums mostly consist of daily wage earners and migrant laborers for whom their livelihood is of vital importance.
One of the important problems that we are facing here is in the area of education, where there is a very high dropout rate from schools, and the children who drop out usually gravitate to crime.
Ramakrishna Mission Mumbai is trying to arrest these problems through the GAP program, providing a contrasting healthy atmosphere and quality education through modern contemporary methods.
Our teachers here actually make all the worksheets and various study material for the children to work with.
To prevent school dropouts, after school tuitions are also arranged for the slum children.
These children are extremely proactive, and they see themselves as future change makers.
The children's all-round personality development is reflected in their implementation of learning. They proactively bring other students to school. Their health awareness and habits of cleanliness help to improve their surroundings.
ये प्रतीक्षा नगर का बहुत बड़ा कचरा पेटी है। हमारा प्रॉब्लम ये है कि ये कचरा पेटी जब भर जाता है, तब इसका कचरा सब रास्ते पे आने लगता है।
ये हमारा टीम है।
हम इसे साफ रखेंगे।
हम इसे साफ रखेंगे।
Marked by the grandeur of the mighty Somnath and Dwarka temples, the state of Gujarat stands as an epitome of spirituality, heritage, vibrant lives of people, and development. This state has memories of Mahatma Gandhi and the memorable visit of Swami Vivekananda. The western part of Gujarat is known as the Run of Kutch. Amidst the scorching sun and thorny bushes, this remote region is home to the Parkara Koli community. Just 40 kilometers from the Pakistan border, these tribes reside in small groups of families known as Vand. Basic ideas of hygiene and education are lacking. Superstitions, poverty, unemployment, complete illiteracy forced these families throughout their entire lives to migrate from one place to another in search of a livelihood. On this noble location of Swamiji's 150th birth anniversary, Ramakrishna Mission Rajkot is fighting against the drawbacks of this area. In Bhuravand, the GAP school is the only existing initiative that is fighting illiteracy and ignorance. As the first generation of schoolgoers, initially, it was extremely difficult to make them sit for 2 to 3 hours. Now, there are 30 children who have slowly learned to pay attention. Today, there is an atmosphere of learning, and through education, they have found the purpose of their lives. At Sakaria Vand, apart from conventional education, the GAP project inculcates traditional values and sense of respect. These 25 children attend school on a regular basis, even though they have to travel huge distances. Recreational activities in school provide vital food for thought and development. The GAP school at Khandlek is now an inseparable part of the lives of the people. Now they have moved away from their ideas of a nomadic existence, lest the education of the children is hampered. The 55 students now realize the importance of education. Here, Project GAP runs an objective to spread knowledge. For this Parkarakoli community, the school has become a window into the wider world. At Jilarvand, severe lack of water results in barren land with no hope of cultivation. Poverty and unemployment is rampant. Ramakrishna Mission Rajkot took the initiative to identify this core problem through constant efforts and discussions with the community. Today, through AKSP, they have installed a water pump to counter water scarcity in the area. And this has eventually become the lifeline of the community. The once arid land has now become fertile and provide for ample crop production. Unemployment has been eradicated and massive socio-economic growth has taken place in this region. The city of Bhuj fell prey to the devastating earthquake of 2001. Today, it is working hard to restore itself. Under the AKSP project, young men and women are being trained in various skills. These skills enable them to gain confidence and self-esteem, making them self-employed.
आज तक 215 लोग यहाँ से तालीम ले गए और हमको उम्मीद है कि ये तालीम उनको अपने जीवन में पूरा उपयोगी होगी.
The VSPP project in Bhuj enrolled 113 families. Adult literacy is a unique approach of the project, encouraging women arriving every day to learn something new with enthusiasm. Upleta is a village near Rajkot. It boasts of one of the most successful SPVP projects, where women participate in various training activities, including computer knowledge. Six 600 women have already benefited from it, while another 150 are under training. Apart from quality education, they are also given marketing support. Not only that, medical and moral awareness camps are also organized for them. The training provides them with a firm confidence to accomplish their new journey.
Jai Swamiji!
The Ramakrishna Mission Rajkot even concentrates upon building the future nation through their half-day youth special programs. Students from different schools come to the ashram where they learn about the life and teachings of Swami Vivekananda.
Apart from academic skills, life skills are very important. And as Swami Vivekananda used to believe, he wanted young men with muscles of iron and nerves of steel.
Weekly camps are also organized for children of different age groups like interactive classes on moral values, yoga, bhajans, leading to character building of these children. The whole day camps urge the youth to indulge in social work, preparing a sound mind in a sound body. These camps prepare them as service corps. Swamiji's philosophy of be and make create a great impact on their young, energetic minds. Swamiji's concept of self-awakening has been implemented in an effective way.
The greatest effect will come when we decide to awaken ourselves.
Through counseling by professionals and interactive sessions, the youth are rediscovering themselves.
Organized in a complete spirit of freedom, where the students are allowed to describe their own aspirations and discover their own, what are the roots that are needed. They learn to classify them on their own, but finally what happens is that they reach a point where they recognize that they need to do something about building their own strength. And once they do that, they are beginning to act upon what Swamiji has asked people to act, which is to develop strength.
Ramakrishna Mission Rajkot is translating and printing curriculum-based books on values in the Gujarati language, targeting each and every school in the state. The Rajkot Center then approaches various schools to adapt them in their curriculum. Teachers and students both enjoy the moral education lessons equally through the interactive way.
I will get the lunch ready by the time you return. So, where did you get it from? Shyam asked, a little amazed. If I try to teach them, it will not make sense. But if it's in a form of a story, kids will understand better and they will catch on to it if it's done over a sustained period of time. So books like this, I'm very sure, will make a big difference in a child.
Now, we take a turn towards the southern region of India, where epics reverberate in modernity. Bengaluru, the capital of Karnataka, is a place with which the history of the Ramakrishna Mission is intricately involved. Being the IT capital of our nation, this city is studded with a high-profile lifestyle and rapid urbanization. Just 20 kilometers out of this vibrant city is Shivanahalli, a place located inside a dense forest, devoid of urban amenities and any medical facilities. The distress and day-to-day hardship of the local people is in stark contrast to modern city life. In the two villages, 300 families who depend entirely on agriculture suffer from illiteracy and ignorance. Ramakrishna Mission Shivanahalli, through GAP, has brought the light of education to the entire village. The school, located in the lap of nature, offers the most enjoyable part of the day in the life of the kids who attend it. Here, they regularly learn about health and hygiene. Learning about their culture and recreational activities also help in their all-round development.
This is our
Born in the midst of nature, they grow and develop, blending the wildness of it with the sharp edge of technology. The VSPP project in Shivanahalli reaches out to 480 children in 12 backward villages, catering to their daily needs and taking care of any health-related troubles. Moreover, books and moral education are also distributed by Ramakrishna Mission Shivanahalli. Not only for children, but Ramakrishna Mission Shivanahalli is also working for the men and women of this village. The AKSP project encourages unemployed villagers to come out of their homes with a new hope. Various quality training and marketing support, generating a confidence in them to combat year-long poverty. Through forming self-help groups, the project enables the local women to save their hard-earned money.
Jai Shri Guru Maharaj ki,
Jai,
Jai Shri Mahamayi ki,
Jai,
Jai Shri Swami Ji Maharaj ki,
Jai.
Shiva Mada and his brother are the sparks of this project. Their success story will inspire every single person suffering from unemployment across the nation. Mysore is one of the remarkable historical places of Karnataka. It holds a special importance in the life of Swami Vivekananda. Mysore Ashram has undertaken the task of translating the books on values education into Kannada and has spread them to various schools. RIMSE is a premier educational institution run by the Ramakrishna Ashram, Mysore. They have been actively involved in imparting values education to its students.
Education is only panacea for all the problems, because India is facing lot of problems without having proper education.
Language and appearance and his ideas also attracted people.
The nature classes spread out a very positive notion among the school kids.
Each person is potentially divine. This is what Swami Vivekananda wants to tell us.
The Mysore Ashram also organizes values education camps for the school students. Participation by a large number of urban youth shows how much Swami Vivekananda's message is relevant even today. Chennai, one of our metro cities of our nation, has been blessed by the footsteps of Swami Vivekananda in the past. Ennur, far from the prerogatives of the metro city, the village resides by a river polluted with industrial waste. Such an unhealthy environment is silently killing the future generation. Moreover, children are growing amidst domestic violence, which is vehemently rampant here. To create a new enlightened generation, Ramakrishna Mission Chennai has started a GAP initiative in Ennur. Mental and physical development is nurturing them every day. Uniquely, the GAP center, attached with the temple, creates immense spiritual and moral impact upon children, helping in carrying forward their rich cultural heritage.
Om Namah Krishna Deva Murti.
Thanjavur is a historical place, once the home of the mighty Chola Empire. The ashram runs their VSPP program here, mainly for the welfare of the children and women. Healthcare camps and values education, as well as physical exercises, are being practiced for their all-round development.
The children, lactating mothers and pregnant women, they come here regularly and they say they are highly benefited by whatever we are giving them.
The people of Ulandarpet village bask in the glory of one of the most successful SPVP projects. The monks of the Ramakrishna Mission are revered here by these people because it is due to their relentless efforts that they have left behind a past of poverty and unemployment. Large numbers of residents in this village earlier suffered from malnutrition. Thanks to the initiative of the Ramakrishna Mission, who had distributed hundreds of fruit trees to these people, they have recovered from these deficiencies to a large extent. The women here under SPVP receive training in tailoring, jewelry making, candle making, and many other skills. They had also received cows as a means of livelihood, along with veterinary support. Many of these women have successfully started their community business by selling milk. One of them is a widow who, after the demise of her husband, started doing this business, is now economically independent. They have reason to celebrate as SPVP has given them a new lease of life. In Chennai city, Ramakrishna Mission Students' Home Mailapur conducts weekly camps on value education for the orphan students, where they undertake physical, mental, and spiritual transformation. Together, these students march forward as one unit with zeal and vigor to gift our country a splendid, enlightened future. Ramakrishna Mission has selected the printed word and parallelly is running a campaign to spread Swamiji's essential message to the masses. Books about Swami Vivekananda's short life and his teachings have already been published in different regional languages. They are being circulated amongst different age groups across various outlets and government libraries. At Hyderabad, the beautiful city of the Charminar, Ramakrishna Mission has its central infrastructure for translating, printing, sorting, packaging, and distribution of these books, adapting languages not listed in the Indian Constitution, is another breakthrough effort to communicate Swamiji's ideals to reach the unreached masses. In West Bengal, Ramakrishna Mission Gold Park is heading the organization's nationwide electronic media campaign. animation films for children, and multimedia presentations on Swamiji's message are nearing completion. A feature-length biopic on Swami Vivekananda is also at an advanced stage of planning. The mission is also using the youth's most preferred media to propagate Swamiji's ideologies. It is beyond our journey's scope to cover the massive geography of this nation entirely. This is just a representative glimpse of a first-of-its-kind nationwide exercise. Funded by the Government of India, Ramakrishna Mission is running 320 units of service-oriented projects across the country. Under the youth special programs, various state and regional level competitions on elocution, debate, essay and quiz were conducted on this occasion. State level youth camps and youth conventions were also conducted by Ramakrishna Mission. Apart from it, seminars on religious and interfaith harmony at the national and state levels and various cultural programs were organized on this occasion across the country. All these activities truly reflect Swami Vivekananda's belief in a classless and casteless society as the basis of a new India. A celebration of mammoth initiatives that are changing lives, making a difference, in a tribute to this great man's memory, to build a better India.
ये देश हमारा।